Hello friends, in the last video we have seen hybridizations of carbon in alkanes, alkenes and alkynes, that is sp3, sp2 and sp hybridization in the various hydrocarbons we have seen. Now today we have to see hybridization of oxygen and nitrogen in the various organic compounds. So organic compounds such as carbonyl compounds, alcohols, ether which contain oxygen. Then in case of nitrogen containing compounds, amines, nitriles, amides, so these are the compounds which contain nitrogen. So I have to see the hybridization of oxygen and nitrogen in the different organic compounds. First of all, we have to see hybridization of oxygen. So I have to see first sp3 hybridization of oxygen. So electronic configuration of oxygen is, we have to find out, first oxygen is having atomic number 8, then its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2 and 2p4. So there are 6 electrons in its outermost shell. So second shell is having 2 plus 4, these are the 6 electrons. So it needs two electrons to complete its octet, hence its valency is 2, hence the oxygen is divalent, because it needs 2 electrons to complete its octet. Now when we see its electron arrangement in this, so this is 1s, this is 2s and this is 2p. Now these are the 2 electrons in 1s orbital, these are the 2 electrons in 2s orbital, and these are the 3 sub orbitals for 2p, in which these are the 4 electrons. In these 4 electrons, first all the electrons go singly, then it get paired. So according to the Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity, first all the electrons go singly in the all degenerate or all equivalent energy orbitals, then they get paired from the first sub orbital. So here these are the 2px is having, this is 2px, 2py and this is here 2pz. So here these are the 2 electrons here in the 2s, 2 electrons in the 2px, and next 2 are having unpaired electrons in 2py and 2pz. This is the electronic arrangement in the ground state. But what happened in the hybridized state? So in the hybridized state, this 1s is as it is having 2 electrons, but here this 2s and this 2p combines each other. So they combines here, and after combination energy of this 2s slightly increase while 2p is slightly decrease. So we will have here these 4 new orbitals, 1, 2, 3, 4, in which 1s is there and 3p are there. So total 4 orbitals are there, in which 1s and 3p, hence it is called as s1p3 hybrid orbitals. And here this first orbital is having 2 electrons, this is also having 2 electrons. Now the next 2 orbitals are having single electron. So this is here the sp3 hybridization by the combination of this s orbital and these 3 orbitals. So 1 s orbital and 3 p orbitals undergoes mixing and recasting to give new 4 orbitals having identical orientation in a space, nearly same energy. So these are the 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals. So in these 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals, if you see, oxygen is having this 1, this 2, this 3 and this 4. So but in this 4, here these 2 orbitals are having 2 electrons. So this is the electron pair here, this is electron pair here, and in these 1 electron is here and 1 electron is here. So these 2 sp3 hybrid orbitals contain complete electron pair. So it is having electron pair. So these are the 2 sp3 hybrid orbitals contain electron pair. So these are the two electrons pair are there in the two sp3 hybrid orbitals, while one is having only one electron. So these orbitals are forming sigma bond. Electrons or non-bonding electron pair. While these are forming sigma bonds. So these two will form sigma bonds. Now here this sigma bond can be formed by this oxygen. This one sp3 hybrid orbital overlaps with one of the atom, and this is overlaps with another atom. So if you see here the example of simple methanol, so that is CH3OH. Now this carbon is having sp3 hybridization, as we have seen, and this oxygen is also having sp3 hybridization. So here this, if you see here, hydrogen, this oxygen is having two lone pair of electron, this one and this two. So these are the two lone pairs of electron. Now this hydrogen is there, overlaps with sp3 hybrid orbital of this oxygen, and this one is suppose methyl carbon. So here this carbon is overlaps here, and this is here CH3. So this carbon, one of the sp3 orbital, this is sp3 hybrid orbital, this is this is here also sp3 hybrid orbital, forms sigma bond. Here it also forms sigma bond. So these are the two sigma bonds formed here. So this oxygen is having this non-bonding electron pair, this non-bonding electron pair, here this hydrogen, this sigma bond is formed, and here there is a carbon and it is having three hydrogens. So this is another sigma bond is formed between this carbon and oxygen. So this is here the carbon is having another three sigma bonds with hydrogen. In this way methanol molecule formed through sp3 hybridization of oxygen. We know the hybridization of carbon. In the sp3 hybridization of carbon, we have seen this. Now here we have to see only the hybridization of oxygen. If you see hybridization of oxygen, simple hybridization of oxygen in the water molecule, if you see example of water, actually water is not a organic compound, but here just the sake of understanding in hybridization in water, we have to see this oxygen is having this one sp3 hybrid orbital, this second sp3, and here this overlaps with hydrogen. So this is sigma bond, this is here sigma bond, it forms water molecule H2O. So in the H2O oxygen is there, this and this hydrogen. So due to the repulsion between these non-bonding electron pairs and this bond electron pairs, there is a repulsion takes place between them. So these are the lone pair of electrons, or these are called as non-bonding electron pair, because these are not bonded to any other species or atom. So these are non-bonding electron pairs. These are also called as unshared electron pairs, because these are not shared, these are only located in the sp3 hybrid orbital of oxygen. So these are unshared. So because of this, they repel each other. There is a maximum repulsion between lone pair, as per the VSEPR theory. There is a maximum repulsion between these two lone pairs. So because of that, they repels here each other, and again they repels here this hydrogen, and they repels here this. So this bond angle is not definitely 109 degree 28 minutes, or 109.5 degree. It is less than 109.5 degree. It is around 105 degree, we can say. So it is 105 degree, but not the one, because of this repulsion. These are the two lone pairs, both the lone pairs repel each other. So because of this repulsion, it pushes both the sigma bonds in the downward direction. So these both sigma bonds shifted in a downward direction, so the bond angle between this bond and this bond with respect to this oxygen is decreased. So it is nearly 105 in case of this methanol. If you see the example of dimethyl ether, see the next example, डाईमिथाइल ईथर दैट इज CH3O CH3. सो सी हियर दिस इज द डाईमिथाइल ईथर. इन दिस डाईमिथाइल ईथर दिस ऑक्सीजन इज हैविंग टू लोन पेयर्स, दिस वन दिस टू. सो हियर दिस वन CH3, दिस अदर CH3. सो इट इज हैविंग एंगुलर शेप. सो दिस इज हैविंग एंगुलर और नॉन लिनियर और नॉन लिनियर. सो दिस इज लाइक दिस. सो हियर दिस मिथिल एंड दिस मिथिल, दिस सिग्मा बॉन्ड, हियर दिस सिग्मा बॉन्ड बिटवीन ऑक्सीजन एंड कार्बन एंड बोथ द लोन पेयर्स रिपेल इच अदर. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस रिपल्शन बॉन्ड एंगल ऑफ दिस टेट्राहेड्रल मॉलिक्यूल गेट रिड्यूस. एक्चुअली द मॉलिक्यूल्स आर टेट्राहेड्रल बट हाइब्रिडाइजेशन इन sp3, बट द बॉन्ड एंगल इज नॉट 109.5 degree, द बॉन्ड एंगल इज 104 to 105 degree. सो हियर दिस इज द केस वी हैव सीन फॉर sp3 हाइब्रिडाइजेशन ऑफ ऑक्सीजन. नाउ हैव टू सी द नेक्स्ट एग्जाम्पल फॉर sp2 हाइब्रिडाइजेशन ऑफ ऑक्सीजन. sp2 hybridization of oxygen. Now if you see the sp2 hybridization of oxygen, then here the ground state electronic configuration is same, but in the sp2 hybridization what happened in the hybridized state, this 1s and this 2p orbitals combines here and we get here 3 orbitals 1 2 3, and here there is a 1, this is 2p z orbital, here this is sp2 hybrid orbitals. So these are formed by combining this 1 2s orbital and this 2 2p orbitals, 1s and 2p orbitals undergoes mixing and recasting to give new 3 orbitals, and here these are the 2 electrons here. These are the 2 electrons here, and this is having 1 1 electron, that is unpaired electron. Now here this orbital is responsible to form, because it is unhybridized, it is responsible to form pi bond with adjacent perpendicular p orbital of the carbon or any other species, while here this is responsible to form sigma bond. So it responsible to form sigma bond, this responsible to for pi bond, and these are the 2 non bonding electron pairs, because these are unshared electron pairs, or these are called as lone pair of oxygen. So this is here sp2 hybridization and sp2 hybrid orbitals. Here this overlaps with adjacent orbital of sp2 hybrid orbital of any species and forms here sigma bond, or any atom forms here sigma bond, and here it forms pi bond. Now see here the orbital picture of this oxygen. Now see here the oxygen is having this perpendicular pz orbital having this 1 electron, and here these are the 1 2 and this 3. So these are the 3 sp3 hybrid orbitals. This is 1, this is 1, and this is third one. So these are the 3 sp2 hybrid orbitals, and here this is perpendicular to this. Suppose these are lying the plane of this board, this perpendicular p orbital is there, this is perpendicular pz orbital to this 3 sp2 hybrid orbitals. Now when we see the example of carbonyl compound, such as simple example we can take here this C double bond O, and here there is hydrogen, this is formaldehyde. Simplest example of carbonyl. Now here this oxygen is there. In this oxygen here these are the 2 lone pair of electrons, these are the 2 lone pair of electron, and this 1 is there in this orbital. Now this overlaps with carbon. Carbon is also having sp2 hybridization, this is also having sp2, Now this carbon is having this 1, this 2 and this 3. These are hydrogens here with carbon. So this is here the sigma bond. This is sigma bond. Now here this 1, this carbon is having sp2 hybridization. So this is 1 electron from carbon, 1 electron from oxygen makes sigma bond. This is your sigma bond. Now this carbon is having perpendicular p orbital to it. This one perpendicular p orbital overlaps here laterally and forms pi bond. So here there is a pi bond. So here this is one pi bond, this is sigma bond, and this is here the oxygen is having this one lone pair, this second lone pair, non-bonding electron pair. So these are the two non-bonding electron pairs of oxygen, and this is carbon is having two hydrogens. Here I have shown here in this orbital diagram. This is sp2, this is sp2. Only one sp2 hybrid orbital overlaps with another sp2 hybrid orbital of carbon, form sigma bond. So when the carbon oxygen in the sp2 hybridization, it forms only one sigma bond and one is pi bond. So it forms one sigma and one pi, two are the non-bonding electron pairs. So here this is the planar molecule. This is here trigonal planar molecule, because of the both carbons and this oxygen lie in the plane, hydrogens are also lie in the plane. This carbon, two hydrogens and this oxygen lie in the plane. So it is a planar molecule. If you see another example of the compound contain oxygen, that is acetone. Second example, acetone. What is the structure of acetone? CH3CO CH3. Now see the hybridization of carbon and oxygen here. Now here when the carbon is having one double bond, it is having sp2 hybridization. It is also having sp2 hybridization. This carbon is sp3. Here this carbon is sp3. Now see this carbon and this oxygen is there. These are forming sigma bond, carbon and oxygen, and this carbon is having two carbons here, 1, 2, and this oxygen is having only carbon. So these are the two orbitals in which lone pairs are there. So these are the two lone pairs in the sp2 hybrid orbitals, while these sp2 hybrid orbitals of carbon form sigma bond with carbons or methyl. This is CH3, this is CH3, this sigma and this sigma. Now this carbon, this oxygen is having one perpendicular p orbital, and here these are forming pi bond by the lateral overlapping. It forms pi bond here. So these are the two sp2 hybrid orbitals contain lone pairs, or that is non-bonding electron pairs or unshared electron pairs of oxygen, and here it forms sigma bond and this one is pi bond. So here this one is sigma bond, other is pi bond. Now if you see the example of acid such as carboxylic acid, if you see your example of second example CH3 C double bond O OH, acetic acid. Now in the acetic acid, see the hybridization. This carbon is here tetrahedral, this carbon is here having sp2 hybridization, this is here again tetrahedral. So here this is sp2, oxygen is sp2. When the one double bond is there with oxygen or one carbon, it is having sp2 hybridization. This is sp3, oxygen is here sp3. Now I do see hybridization of this oxygen as well as this oxygen in the acetic acid. Now see the structure of this compound. Carbon is having oxygen and here this oxygen. So this carbon is having two oxygens, or we can say here this carbon is having, this oxygen is having sigma bond. These are the two lone pairs, and this one sp2 hybrid orbital दिस वन sp2 हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल ऑफ दिस ऑक्सीजन ओवरलैप्स एंड फॉर्म्स पाई बॉन्ड. सो दिस इज पाई बॉन्ड बिटवीन दिस. सो हियर दिस इज द पाई बॉन्ड. ओके नाउ वी हैव हियर सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ सिग्मा बॉन्ड एंड दिस इज द इलेक्ट्रॉन पेयर. दिस इज सिग्मा बॉन्ड. दिस आर द लोन पेयर्स और नॉन बॉन्डिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन पेयर्स इन द sp2 हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल्स. नाउ दिस कार्बन इज हैविंग मिथाइल एंड ऑक्सीजन. सो हियर इट इज हैविंग sp2 हाइब्रिडाइजेशन. इट इज हैविंग दिस ऑक्सीजन. सो हियर दिस ऑक्सीजन इज देयर. दिस ऑक्सीजन इज हैविंग अगेन हाइड्रोजन एंड टू लोन पेयर्स. दिस वन एंड दिस सेकंड एंड दिस हाइड्रोजन. सो इट इज sp3 हाइब्रिड. सो सी हियर दिस sp3 हाइब्रिड. दिस वन इलेक्ट्रॉन पेयर. दिस इज सेकंड लोन पेयर. And here this is OH. So here this is hydrogen. Sigma bond, lone pairs. So these are the 1, 2, and 3. So these are actually here this is the hybridization overlapping of. This is sigma bond. sp2 hybrid orbital of carbon overlaps with sp3 hybrid orbital of oxygen. This is sp2 hybrid orbital of carbon overlaps with sp3 hybrid orbital of oxygen form sigma bond. And here there is a methyl. So here there is a methyl H and this H. So here this is sigma bond. This is sp3 while this is here sp2. So this sp2 hybrid orbital of carbon overlaps with sp3 hybrid orbital of methyl carbon. This one forms sigma bond. So this is sigma bond. Here this is sigma bond between oxygen. This is here carbon. This is here oxygen. So in this way, this is the acetic acid CH3COOH. So here this is CH3 C double bond O OH. So this is pi bond. So C O. This is here sigma. This pi. Here this is CH3. Here this is OH. Here these are the lone pairs. Here is also two lone pairs. So in this way, this is the example of CH3COOH acetic acid. So in this way, these are the examples of compounds of carbon oxygen we have seen, in which hybridization sp3 as well as sp2 for the oxygen we have discussed here. Now the next way to see nitrogen sp3 hybridization of nitrogen. See the electronic configuration of nitrogen. Nitrogen is having atomic number 7. So 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. So in the vacant valence shell 2 plus 3, 5 electrons are there. So how many electrons required to complete its octet? 3. So nitrogen is basically trivalent in the organic compound. So 5 electrons in the outermost shell, 3 electrons required to complete its octet. So valency of nitrogen is 3 in case of our organic compounds. Now I have to see the arrangements of electrons in the orbitals. So this is 1s, this is 2s, and this is here 2p. So 1s is having 2 electrons, 2s is having 2 electrons. Now this 2p is having 3 electrons. So, as per the our maximum multiplicity principle, so all the electrons first go singly in the degenerate orbitals. So all the electrons here feel singly in the all sub orbitals of 2p. Now in the this is ground state picture in the ground state. Now what happened in the hybridized state? Hybridized state. So here this 1s as it is, but here this 2s and 2p means 1s orbital and this 3p orbitals are undergoes mixing, and they gives here new set of 4 orbitals 1, 2, 3, 4. So energy of this is slightly higher than 2s and lesser than 2p. So here these are the 2 electrons 1 1 1 1 1 and this 1. So these are the sp3 hybrid orbitals. So these are here the sp3 hybrid orbitals. 2 electrons are there here इन दी वन sp3 हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल व्हाइल थ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर अनपेड. नाउ दीज आर थ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन्स अनपेड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर फॉर्मिंग सिग्मा बॉन्ड्स. सो दीज थ्री आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू फॉर्म थ्री सिग्मा बॉन्ड्स बिकॉज दीज आर दी पार्ट ऑफ हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल्स एंड दिस इज नथिंग बट लोन पेयर और नॉन बॉन्डिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन पेयर पजेस्ड बाय नाइट्रोजन इन sp3 हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल. नाउ सी हियर द एग्जाम्पल. इफ यू सी द सिंपलेस्ट एग्जाम्पल ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड कंटेन नाइट्रोजन दैट इज मिथेनामाइन CH3NH2. Now see the nitrogen's hybridization. Nitrogen is having this one. So these are the four sp3 hybrid orbitals in which one is having this electron pair. So the shape of this orbital is not tetrahedral, it is pyramidal. Because of the repulsion between this and this. So here they repel each other. Because of this repulsion, bond angle get shortened for this sigma bonds. Now here if you see the example of CH3NH2, so here this nitrogen is having one lone pair, so which is there in this, so two hydrogens are there, so this is one hydrogen, this is second hydrogen, form sigma bond here. Now this one methyl, this carbon is having again sp3 hybridization. So this carbon is having sp3 hybridization and these three are the hydrogens attached to this, so it forms sigma bond. So this sigma and this sigma, so in this way this forms molecule like nitrogen. This is sp3 hybrid orbital contain lone pair of electrons, this hydrogen and this CH3. So the shape is pyramidal for this nitrogen. But if you see here this carbon is having again sp3 hybridization and its shape is tetrahedral because it is CH3 3 sigma bonds and this one sigma bond with nitrogen. So here this carbon is having tetrahedral hybrid geometry while the nitrogen is having shape pyramid. If you see the simple example of ammonia, actually ammonia is not organic compound but it is very simple to explain hybridization of ammonia. Nitrogen is having three hydrogens, so here this nitrogen is having these three orbitals overlaps here with hydrogen. So this is one sigma, this is second sigma, this is third sigma. So here these three sigma bonds are formed, so shape of the ammonia is pyramidal and repulsion is there, so the bond angle is less, it is around 107 degree, but not the tetrahedral bond angle of our carbon is 109.5, it is less than this, so that is 107 degree because of the repulsion between lone pair and bond pair. So because of the repulsion between non bonding electron pair, that is the unshared electron pair and the bonding electron pairs, so the hybrid repulsion causes shortening of bond angle, so bond angle is definitely less. So here these bond angles are less than 109.5 degree, so it is basically 107 to 108 degree, depends on the nature of this alkyl group, so the bond angle can be changes from 107 to 108 degree in case of sp3 hybrid orbital of hybridized nitrogen. So here we can have the different examples, methanamine, ethanamine, propanamine, all primary amines, nitrogen is having sp3 hybridization. So one is lone pair, that is non bonding electron pair, two are form sigma bond with hydrogens and one is with alkyl group. So in this way this is the sp3 hybridization of nitrogen, here we have discussed. Now we have to see next hybridization, that is sp2 hybridization of nitrogen. Now we have to see sp2 hybridization of nitrogen in which we have to see this same ground state electronic configuration, but in the hybrid state what happen, दिस वन एंड दिस टू आर मिक्सिंग. सो वन एस ऑर्बिटल एंड टू पी ऑर्बिटल्स अंडरगोज मिक्सिंग टू गिव न्यू थ्री ऑर्बिटल्स इन विच वन इज हैविंग दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन पेयर. दिस आर वन हाफ फिल्ड एंड दिस वन इज हियर दैट इज टू पी जेड ऑर्बिटल. टू पी जेड ऑर्बिटल है दिस इज एस पी टू हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल्स एस वन टू पी. सो वन एस एंड टू पी ऑर्बिटल्स आर फॉर्मिंग एस पी टू हाइब्रिडाइजेशन. वॉट इज एस पी टू? वन एस एंड टू पी ऑर्बिटल्स अंडरगोज मिक्सिंग एंड रिकास्टिंग टू गिव न्यू सेट ऑफ थ्री ऑर्बिटल्स विच इज नोन एज एस पी टू हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल्स एंड द फेनोमेनन इज नथिंग बट एस पी टू हाइब्रिडाइजेशन. नाउ सी द एस पी टू हाइब्रिडाइजेशन ऑफ नाइट्रोजन. सो हियर दिस इज द नाइट्रोजन विच इज हैविंग एस पी टू हाइब्रिडाइजेशन. सो दिज आर द थ्री एस पी टू हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल्स वाइल दिस वन इज परपेंडिकुलर पी जेड ऑर्बिटल. सो हियर दिज आर द एक्चुअली टू इलेक्ट्रॉन्स हियर. दिस टू इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर देयर इन दिस इज द लोन पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन दैट इज नॉन बॉन्डिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन पेयर. हियर दिस इज वन इलेक्ट्रॉन. हियर दिस इज वन इलेक्ट्रॉन. सो इट फॉर्म्स टू सिग्मा बॉन्ड्स. सो दिज आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू फॉर्म टू सिग्मा बॉन्ड्स. दिस इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू फॉर्म पाई बॉन्ड बिकॉज इट इज परपेंडिकुलर टू दिस थ्री ऑर्बिटल्स एंड हियर इट इज द लोन पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन नाइट्रोजन नॉन बॉन्डिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन पेयर ऑफ नाइट्रोजन. सो दिस इज वन. दिस वन इज फॉर्मिंग सिग्मा बॉन्ड. दिस वन इज फॉर्मिंग सिग्मा बॉन्ड वाइल दिस इज परपेंडिकुलर टू दिस थ्री ऑर्बिटल्स. नाउ इफ यू सी द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ एस पी टू हाइब्रिड नाइट्रोजन कंटेनिंग कंपाउंड देन वी हैव इमाइन. इमाइन सो हियर नाइट्रोजन इज हैविंग डबल बॉन्ड विथ हियर दिस सिंपल कार्बन सी एच टू हियर दिस एन एच. सो इमाइन विथ सिंपल फॉर्मल्डिहाइड इट फॉर्म्स इमाइन. सो दिस इमाइन एन एच डबल बॉन्ड सी एच टू. सो हियर एन एच मीन्स हियर दिस वन सिग्मा बॉन्ड विथ कार्बन वन सिग्मा बॉन्ड विथ हाइड्रोजन. सो हियर दिस इज हाइड्रोजन सिग्मा बॉन्ड. हियर दिस इज विथ कार्बन. दिस कार्बन इज हैविंग टू हाइड्रोजन्स एंड हियर दिस इज सिग्मा बॉन्ड एंड वन न्यू पाई बॉन्ड विथ वन एस पी परपेंडिकुलर पी ऑर्बिटल ऑफ कार्बन ओवरलैप्स लैटरली एंड फॉर्म्स हियर पाई बॉन्ड. सो वी हैव हियर दिस. सी दिस इज नाइट्रोजन इज हैविंग लोन पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन. दिस इज हाइड्रोजन. हियर देर इज अ कार्बन. हियर देर इज अ हाइड्रोजन. हियर हाइड्रोजन. दिस इज सिग्मा बॉन्ड एंड अनदर इज पाई बॉन्ड. दिस वन इज पाई बॉन्ड. दिस सिग्मा बॉन्ड. सो हियर इट इज हैविंग दिस एस पी टू हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल. दिस एस पी टू एंड दिस एस पी टू फॉर्म सिग्मा एंड दिस इज देर इन द लोन पेयर इज देर इन द एस पी टू हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल एंड दिस कार्बन इज हियर प्लेनर वेल हियर इट इज हियर इट इज ऑल्सो प्लेनर. लोन पेयर हाइड्रोजन एंड दिस सिग्मा बॉन्ड लाइन वन प्लेन. सो दिस आर लाइन वन प्लेन एंड दिस कार्बन इज ऑल्सो लाइन दिस वन प्लेन. सो इन दिस वे दिस इज इमाइन. नाउ वी हैव सी एच थ्री सी डबल बॉन्ड एन एच. हियर दिस इज हाइड्रोजन. नाउ हियर अगेन दिस नाइट्रोजन इज हैविंग एस पी टू हाइब्रिडाइजेशन. दिस इज ऑल्सो हैविंग एस पी टू हाइब्रिडाइजेशन. सो हियर दिस नाइट्रोजन इज हैविंग एस पी टू. दिस कार्बन इज हैविंग दिस इज प्लेनर. दिस इज ऑल्सो प्लेनर बिकॉज वन लोन पेयर एंड दिस हाइड्रोजन एक्चुअली एच एंड दिस सिग्मा बॉन्ड इज एंगुलर. दिस इज हियर एस पी थ्री. दिस इज हियर टेट्राहेड्रल. सो इन दिस वे हियर ओनली वी हैव टू रिप्लेस दिस हाइड्रोजन विथ सॉरी दिस वन हाइड्रोजन विथ मिथाइल. सो व्हेन वी रिप्लेस दिस बिकॉज एन एच दिस एन एच इज देयर दिस सी एच एंड सी एस थ्री सी एच एंड दिस सी एस थ्री. सो हियर वी कैन रिप्लेस दिस विथ सी एस थ्री. सो वी गेट द इमाइन ऑफ दिस एसिटाइल डिहाइड विथ सिंपल अमोनिया. सो इन दिस वे दिस इमाइन वी गेट इज हैविंग sp2 हाइब्रिडाइजेशन फॉर नाइट्रोजन, sp2 फॉर कार्बन एंड दिस sp3 फॉर दिस कार्बन. सो नेक्स्ट हाइब्रिडाइजेशन ऑफ नाइट्रोजन वाई टू सी sp हाइब्रिडाइजेशन ऑफ नाइट्रोजन. इन द sp हाइब्रिडाइजेशन ऑफ नाइट्रोजन दिस वन s एंड दिस वन p अंडरगोज मिक्सिंग एंड रिकास्टिंग टू गिव न्यू सेट ऑफ दिस टू ऑर्बिटल्स एंड हियर दिज आर द दिस टू ऑर्बिटल्स दिस वन एंड दिस टू. सो हियर दिस इज हियर इन द हाइब्रिड स्टेट. सो दिस इज हियर एस पी दिस वन एस एंड वन पी वाइल दिज आर दिस इज पी एक्स एंड दिस इज सॉरी दिस इज पी वाई एंड दिस इज पी जेड. सो दिज आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू फॉर्म पाई बॉन्ड. दिस इज हियर लोन पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन वाइल दिस फॉर्म्स सिग्मा बॉन्ड. सो इट विल फॉर्म हियर वन सिग्मा बॉन्ड. नाउ इफ यू सी एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दिस एस पी हाइब्रिडाइज्ड नाइट्रोजन. सो द बेस्ट एग्जाम्पल इज एच सी एन और सी एच थ्री सी एन. सो हियर इफ यू सी सिंपल एग्जाम्पल एच सी एन हाइड्रोजन साइनाइड एंड नेक्स्ट एग्जाम्पल वाई टू सी एसिटोनाइट्राइल सी एस थ्री सी ट्रिपल बॉन्ड इन. नाउ सी द नाइट्रोजन हियर इन द एस पी हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल. नाइट्रोजन इज हैविंग दिस वन एंड दिस टू. दिस वन इज हैविंग लोन पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एंड दिस इज हैविंग वन इलेक्ट्रॉन हियर व्हाइल टू आर द परपेंडिकुलर पी ऑर्बिटल्स. दिस इज वन दिस इज अदर परपेंडिकुलर पी ऑर्बिटल्स आर देयर. वन वन इलेक्ट्रॉन इज देयर इन दिस ईच ऑर्बिटल. नाउ इट इज कंबाइंड विथ हाइब्रिडाइज्ड विथ कार्बन. सो हियर दिस कार्बन इज देयर अगेन इन द एस पी हाइब्रिडाइजेशन. सो दिस वन हियर वन परपेंडिकुलर पी ऑर्बिटल एंड दिस सेकेंड परपेंडिकुलर पी ऑर्बिटल. सो हियर दिस वन दिस कार्बन इज हैविंग अगेन एस पी नाइट्रोजन इज हैविंग एस पी. सो हियर इट फॉर्म्स दिस एस पी एस पी ओवरलैपिंग फॉर्म सिग्मा बॉन्ड एंड दिस कार्बन इज हैविंग सिग्मा बॉन्ड विथ हाइड्रोजन. सो दिस इज एच सी एन. नाउ हियर दिस फॉर्म्स वन पाई बॉन्ड एंड दिस सेकेंड पाई बॉन्ड. सो इन दिस वे दिस पाई एंड दिस पाई बॉन्ड फॉर्म बिटवीन दिस. सो हियर नाइट्रोजन इज हैविंग लोन पेयर नॉन बॉन्डिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन पेयर दिस सिग्मा बॉन्ड दिस वन पाई बॉन्ड दिस इज सेकेंड पाई बॉन्ड सिग्मा बॉन्ड विथ कार्बन एंड दिस कार्बन इज हैविंग हाइड्रोजन. सो हियर दिस इज सिग्मा बॉन्ड दिस इज सिग्मा. सो हियर दिस इज द लीनियर ज्योमेट्री. दिस इज एच सी एन. इफ यू सी द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सी एच थ्री सी ट्रिपल बॉन्ड ई एन. नाउ सी दिस सी एच थ्री इज हैविंग एस पी थ्री हाइब्रिडाइजेशन. दिस सी इज हैविंग एस पी हाइब्रिडाइजेशन. दिस नाइट्रोजन इज हैविंग एस पी हाइब्रिडाइजेशन. नाउ हियर दिस कार्बन एंड नाइट्रोजन इज हैविंग एस पी हाइब्रिडाइजेशन. सो सी हियर नाइट्रोजन कार्बन एंड दिस देन वाई टू सी दिस कार्बन. सो दिस कार्बन एंड दिस नाइट्रोजन एस पी वन लोन पेयर इन द एस पी हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल. दिस इज एस पी हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल कंटेन नॉन बॉन्डिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन पेयर. So this is non-bonding electron pair there in the sp hybrid orbital. Now here this sp and this sp undergoes mixing and undergoes overlapping form sigma bond while this carbon is having this another sp hybrid orbital but this carbon is tetrahedral. This hydrogen hydrogen and hydrogen. So here it forms sigma bond. Here this sigma one perpendicular form one pi bond and the second perpendicular from second pi bond. So in this way this is the compound सी हियर दिस इज पाई बॉन्ड सिग्मा बॉन्ड दिस इज पाई बॉन्ड दिस इज नाइट्रोजन लोन पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन हियर देर इज अ हाइड्रोजन हाइड्रोजन एंड हाइड्रोजन दिस इज एसीटोनाइट्राइल द स्ट्रक्चर इज हियर लिनियर फॉर दिस नाइट्राइल एंड टेट्राहेड्रल फॉर दिस कार्बन सो हियर द शेप ऑफ दिस कार्बन इज टेट्राहेड्रल बट दिस नाइट्राइल इज हियर लिनियर और दिस दिस बॉन्ड एंड दिस बॉन्ड इज हियर कार्बन एंड कार्बन इज हियर 180 डिग्री बॉन्ड एंगल सो इन दिस वे हियर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड डिफरेंट एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ द कंपाउंड सच एज ऑक्सीजन कंटेनिंग कंपाउंड हैविंग sp3 हाइब्रिडाइजेशन ऑक्सीजन कंटेनिंग कंपाउंड हैविंग sp2 हाइब्रिडाइजेशन नाइट्रोजन sp sp2 एंड sp3 वी हैव सीन द डिफरेंट एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ दिस कंपाउंड्स नाउ आई टू सी फ्यू एग्जाम्पल्स एंड देयर हाइब्रिडाइजेशंस एंड शेप ऑफ द मॉलिक्यूल्स H3 C डबल बॉन्ड O NH2 नाउ टेल मी द हाइब्रिडाइजेशन आइडेंटिफाई द हाइब्रिडाइजेशन ऑफ ईच एटम एंड इट्स shape this is acetamide if we have example such as CH3 CH2 OH ethanol if we have CH3 C double bond O H acetaldehyde now we have to see hybridization and geometry of these compounds Oxygen is having sp2 hybridization. Similarly, carbon is having sp2 hybridization. This nitrogen is having sp3 hybridization. This is sp3. When it is single bonded, carbon, nitrogen, or oxygen, when it is single bonded, it must have sp3 hybridization. But when one pi bond is formed by that atom, whether it may be oxygen, nitrogen, or carbon, then it forms. It has sp2 hybridization. If again one pi bond is formed by nitrogen or carbon, then it is having sp hybridization. But sp hybridization is not possible for oxygen. Oxygen is there in the sp3 and sp2. So see here, this is here planar. This is here pyramidal. And here it is tetrahedral. Tetrahedral. Because this carbon is having three bonds with hydrogen and one bond with this carbonyl carbon. But here this is here planar C double bond O and this NH2. Now here if you see its structure then carbon is having this is pi bond this is sigma bond oxygen is having one lone pair and the second lone pair. Now this is the planar carbon is there CH3 this is sigma bond. Here this is sigma bond nitrogen is having two hydrogens and one lone pair so this is pyramidal this is here planar this is here tetrahedral now next is ethanol see the next example ethanol this is sp3 sp3 it is also sp3 so all are sp3 This is here angular because only two bonds are there. If you see the lone pairs, then it is tetrahedral. This is here tetrahedral. This is here shape is tetrahedral. Now see here this oxygen is having two lone pairs, and this one is hydrogen, and this is carbon is having hydrogen, hydrogen, and this carbon, hydrogen, hydrogen, and hydrogen so here it is tetrahedral this is tetrahedral it is also tetrahedral sp3 hybridization but the shape is here angular for the oh and it is nonlinear that is 104 to 105 degree now see the next example acetaldehyde in this acetaldehyde CH3 C double bond oh so here this is planar and here it is tetrahedral this is having sp2 hybridization it is having sp3 hybridization so this is sp3 this is sp2 carbon is there oxygen perpendicular p orbital forms pi bond this is sigma दिस इज पाई एंड दिस ऑक्सीजन इज हैविंग वन हाइड्रोजन एंड वन लोन पेयर. दिस इज हैविंग टू लोन पेयर्स एंड हियर दिस कार्बन इज हैविंग CH3. कार्बोनिल इज हैविंग ऑक्सीजन एंड हाइड्रोजन. सो दिस इज ऑक्सीजन एंड दिस इज हियर हाइड्रोजन एंड दिस इज हियर दिस कार्बन CH3 HHH. सिग्मा बॉन्ड, दिस इज सिग्मा बॉन्ड. सो इन दिस वे दिस इज कार्बोनिल, कार्बन ऑक्सीजन सिग्मा बॉन्ड एंड दिस इज पाई बॉन्ड एंड हियर दिस इज दिस आर द लोन पेयर्स ऑफ ऑक्सीजन. सो इन दिस वे एसिटाल्डिहाइड मॉलिक्यूल इज फॉर्म. एसिटाल्डिहाइड मॉलिक्यूल इज हियर प्लेनर एट कार्बोनिल फेस. सो इन दिस वे हियर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड वेरियस एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ कंपाउंड्स कंटेनिंग ऑक्सीजन एंड नाइट्रोजन अलॉन्ग विद SP3, SP2 एंड SP हाइब्रिडाइजेशन ऑफ नाइट्रोजन एंड SP3 एंड SP2 हाइब्रिडाइजेशन ऑफ ऑक्सीजन इन दी वेरियस कंपाउंड हियर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड. थैंक यू.